This is a great top eight because this is Channel Fireball. And I
it's an obvious idea.
Was this obvious? For some reason I thought it was you, Chion. I was gonna give you credit, but I'll give Avi credit.
Obviously, no.
I'll give Avi credit, and it's only fair that Avi gets credit because he absolutely screwed up the graphics for this top eight by forgetting some of the cards.
It's because Mashi came up with the list, and when Mashi comes up with lists and Raptor doesn't revise them, this is what happens.
I want to say this for this top eight. Normally that's true. I was like, I put a bunch of crap. I put Lava Burst in here. And I was like joking, they're not making changes to this top eight that I inserted two jokes into. But anyway, top eight fireballs. This week's top eight is top eight fireballs. The honorable mention, Avi insisted we bump it for Comet Storm, but the honorable mention is Crater's Claw.
Which only didn't make the list because Mashi didn't realize was a fireball.
Didn't quite realize exactly what it was. That in combination for, you know, Comet Storm, though. Wait,
it's not a fireball if unless you're ferocious, right?
That's what I was thinking.
No, that's not how that works.
So Crater's Claw definitely should be on the list. Yes. Definitely should be on the list. These guys act like they aren't on the message board this is discussed on. So I don't know that all the responsibility lands here.
I was busy sleeping for most of the day.
God, please. Everyone's good at something. I guess you found your niche. Number eight, Avi's favorite card, Comet Storm. And you won a Pro Tour with this in your deck, didn't you, Raptor?
I top 8 a Pro Tour.
Oh, you top 8 a Pro Tour. So you even won a Pro Tour. So you top 8 a Pro Tour.
Paula won a Pro Tour.
What do you think about Comet Storm?
It was good in that tournament.
It was good in block. It was great.
It was good in block constructed and never again anywhere else.
Yeah. So it had its moment. Crater's Claw probably should be above Comet Storm. You're going to hear this a lot during this list. Okay, number 7, Red Sun's Zenith. The reusable fireball, you know? You can kinda,
this one wasn't even good in block construction.
It wasn't really good at anything. We're looking at fireballs. Crater's Claw should be above Red Sun Zenith. But number 7, Red Sun Zenith. It's a fireball that you use, and then you can use again.
Yeah.
And then you can use again.
Yeah.
And then you can use again.
If you're very lucky, it is very good.
Well, we are talking to Lucky Chion, so.
So I was going to say, yeah.
I'm just going to play one in my decks.
I was going to say, most people play four, but when you're Paul Chion, you just play one to save space and just draw it whenever you
need
it.
Cut. Yeah. All right.
You shuffle, you cut, gets you again.
Yes. Thanks for playing.
Number 6, Devil's Play. Yeah. Devil's Play is a good card.
This one's actually a very good card.
Yeah. You could just cast it early, kill a cheap creature or whatever, and then in the late game you just get to flash it back and kill them. Come back. That's really strong.
It has that value that so many flashback cards have where it's like, oh, you forgot about this? Remember this?
Well, you don't really need the "oh, you forgot about it" value for this card to be good.
Well, because it's a ticking time bomb. There's inevitability working with you.
Yeah, you can be staring at it and just like, well, can't beat that.
Right. And the other card that probably should have made the list in similar fashion is Conflagration. Definitely an honorable mention.
Well, that one's very different. Like, that has exactly one purpose, and that is killing your opponent when you draw your entire deck.
Right. But
it has seen a lot of play doing that.
It has the flashback.
Conflagration
is, like, if you're just trying to cast it, obviously, it doesn't even sniff this list. It's just not.
You're never going to.
Like, all the fireballs are red X, getcha.
Or two red X. Or red XX.
For that first one. But Devil's Play, anytime you can get value off of your fireball, being able to buy it back is pretty sick.
Winning.
We could have had Rolling Thunder in there.
Rolling Thunder is more like an earthquake than a fireball, isn't it?
No. It's just actual.
It's a fireball.
Is it a fireball?
That just doesn't cost more to switch targets.
That's what it is. Yeah. You just split it up.
Yeah.
Could have. this is why these guys, but
this is sweet. Like, there's just so many good fireballs where we had to narrow
it down.
There's
so many good ones that we ended up with Red Sun Zenith.
Number five, the original fireball, had to put on the list.
Of course,
had to make the list.
Yeah, I can't believe it's only number 5.
I was trying to be more balanced. I thought some of the things above it weren't going to be above it, to be honest with you. But number 5 is fireball. For old school players, it was a victory condition. It was a way to take out multiple creatures. Particularly if you weren't trying to damage yourself, because Earthquake is a more traditional way. I mentioned Cloud Elemental. That was a thorn in many a side for quite some time, and of course Earthquake doesn't touch that. So it was a way to not only have a victory condition, but to take out multiple creatures or do a little bit of damage and take out creatures, although you really didn't do that. So number 5 is Fireball.
I think we probably did catch some people off guard having it at 5, though. Some people, we could have had it at like 1.
Yeah. And people would have accepted that.
Right. They're like, oh yeah, China Fireball, why not?
No problem.
Yeah.
Number 4, Demon Fire. And there's a theme here. Demon Fire, you know, obviously uncounterable when you got nothing going on in the hand. How do you feel about Demon Fire?
I love playing this card so much with Tron Lands.
Oh,
just 20 geez. People. With
I
that.
Lost.
Yeah.
I mean, like I've said many times before, I hate losing to Tron, and I've died to a lot of Demon Fires.
Demon Fire is good.
It never feels good when you just hear. I used to play with sound, and you just hear it. You hear it click, and then they just start tapping their mana, and it just starts filtering. Filtering. Yeah. I'm like, all right, I'm gonna take 18 here. This is so dumb.
Well, I mean, the beautiful thing about Demon Fire was what I always love about the card, just kind of the feel of the card from an R&D and flavor perspective, is it's kind of like, this is all I got left, and it's enough to get you, and there's nothing you can do about it, right? So, Demon Fire coming in at number four. Number three, in similar fashion, Banefire. Obviously, you get it up above five, and it's uncounterable as well. I think it's uncounterable, undirectable, or unpreventable. Is that what it is? Yeah. Banefire, number four. Thoughts on Banefire?
Yeah, just another very, very powerful fireball effect. Basically, I feel like every set, they're just like, all right, let's have a red X spell.
How can we
make it sweeter
or
a little bit different? And they've tried that, you know, with the Devil's Play, Demon Fire, Bane Fire. It all follows, like, it's not just red X. There's an extra clause that makes it that much better.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, I think they definitely got there with Bane Fire as well. Super powerful effect. And once again, as a blue mage, any fireball that's uncounterable is
a thorn in your side. What I love about...
Not the biggest fan of this top eight, just in general, just because uncountable fireballs.
Says the guy who won't play blue-black in standard. But, so these last two also, you know, what I love about them in terms of fireballs, and fireball for the most part, really designed to go to the dome. That's what they did. They burned you out. They ended games. Number two, some of us up here thought it should be number one. Some of us pushed pretty hard.
Let's just... You guys can guess who thought this should be number one.
If your guess was Channel Fireball President and CEO John Sasso, you would be correct.
Oh my God.
Sasso and I both immediately, when this top eight came up, had the same number one, Care of X-Torch. Care of X-Torch was awesome.
I saw the list.
It still is. It's the only card in this top eight that is currently getting played in Vintage Super League.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Wow.
The thing about Care of X-Torch is just like, it was like, oh, you left two up for Mana Leak because you thought I would, you know, I needed to tap out to kill you, and you know, I need that three mana. Or, oh, you left one up for Disrupt because you want to get value because you want to stop me. Oh, you got a Force Spike or Disrupt. Oh, you got that two mana up for Counterspell. Sorry. Dead. Dead.
I saw this at number two on the list, and I knew exactly who was responsible for this.
I had the number one. I had Torch at number one.
No, I saw the list because I didn't have that much time because, like I said, I was, you know, getting my snooze on. But, I definitely took a peek, and I was just like, yeah, I don't think Kevrick's Torch should be number one, and then it just went back to sleep.
Torch should be number one, no question. Caravex Torch is a sweet fireball. Yeah. And it was actually one of the reasons I wanted this. I was like, oh, Caravex Torch is so sweet.
Yeah, it's like, oh my God, I almost got it just totally, this one just time.
But we have it at number two, though I'm sure most of you agree with me, it should be number one. Coming in at number one, the best fireball in our top eight, Bonfire of the Damned. One red XX. Guys, come on.
That's all you got. That's
one
all
red,
you need.
Yeah. One red
I tried to get Avi to get the GIF on there, but I'll just do it for you.
The best. Oh, the best is.
Who was it? Well, it wasn't Li Shitian, right?
No.
It was from Team Taiwan, though, right?
Yeah.
The best is just like the
oh my God.
The look over.
Oh my God. When that happened, like, you know, we were in Curacao, we're just watching it, and we every single computer station probably replayed that thing about 50 times.
There's a playmat. Someone made a playmat of that shot. Oh my God. It is just.
They were playing it on repeat on Luis's work too, just like for the next week.
Yeah. It was just awesome. If you haven't seen the GIF of it's Kibler, right? Getting blown out by Bonfire.
Kibler with Luis, and then you even see Yelgar in the back. Like, every time I watch it, there's some new story.
There's new element.
Yeah.
Like,
My favorite part is you just see Aaron Forsythe just walking away in disgust.
Yeah.
It's like, oh God, what did I do making this card?
And then you know Yelgar, he just loves a good beat.
Yeah.
So he just looks and he just like, I already know what he's telling. He's like, good beats. You know, like he just like chuckles. Like, just like, oh my God.
You've got to see this GIF. Yeah, if you haven't seen the Bonfire GIF, you got to check it out. It's pretty hilarious. It never gets old. I've probably seen it like two dozen times. I'm always like.
So good.
So there you have it. Our top eight fireballs. We're going to have to redo this list at some point.
It's okay.
But not next week. I assume next week we're doing top eight channels, right?
Top eight channels. That was so funny. So how about top eight channels? We'll look at that. No promises.
Top it's got to be better than top 8 vaults, so.
Anything's better than top 8 vaults. I don't want to hear it, chat. I don't want to hear it. Top 8 fireballs. Coming in at number 8, Comet Storm. Number 7, Red Sun Zenith. Number 6, Devil's Play. Number 5, Fireball. Number 4, Demon Fire. Number 3, Banefire. Number 2, Karavex Torch. And number 1, because it's the gift that keeps on giving, Bonfire of the Damned. That does it for Magic TV this week. Thank you so much for tuning in. We'll be back next Wednesday at 7 o'clock for Josh Utter-Layton, Paul Cheon, and of course, Dark Steel Humphrey. I'm Moshi Scanlon. See you next week, everybody. Woo.